So I made some top 5 videos talking about some video games, animated movies, and this time I want to make another top 5 video. But then I was like, fuck that, I'ma level up and make this a top 10 video. These are my top 10 favorite movies of all time. These are films that I absolutely adore watching again and again, liking it more and more by each rewatch. Before I start the list, I need to make this super clear. These are just my favorite movies, not best. If you're mad that your favorite movie isn't on my list, suck a dick. With that being said, let's start the video. Starting the list off with my number 10 pick, The Dark Crystal. To be honest, I'm not the biggest fan of Jim Henson's work. Now, don't get me wrong, I like some of his stuff. I fuck with some of the Muppets movies, but I wouldn't call myself a fan of those works. However, I can definitely say with confidence that I fucking adore The Dark Crystal. From its dark and magical story, to its fun and likable characters, to its beautifully crafted world that combines the dark but also colorful spirit of the movie, there is so much to like about this movie. Also, I'd like to say this, for a Jim Henson family movie, I'm surprised that there's some complex elements sprinkled into the story. I never thought a Jim Henson property would have elements like this. The Dark Crystal is a fun ride and it's easily the best thing that has the Jim Henson name on it. Number 9, Taxi Driver. A friend of mine recommended this movie to me. He said that I would love this movie, so when I watched it, he was completely right. This movie is incredible. The thing I like the most about Taxi Driver is its down-to-earth and depressing atmosphere, which complements the deep message of the story of what loneliness can really do to someone, especially if that someone is trying to restart his entire life from the ground up like Travis Bickle. Speaking of him, Robert De Niro's performance as the mentally unstable loner is perfection. Seeing his character develop as the story progresses was just incredible. The phenomenal story, characters, and deep themes are complemented by some of the best music I've heard in a feature film. Taxi Driver is a movie that'll really put you into the shoes of a person who just wants to live a better life. Number 8, A Silent Voice. A Silent Voice is the prime definition of an emotional roller coaster. When I was watching this movie, I was feeling all kinds of emotions that I would never expect from an anime movie. This movie has a great story tackling into the concept of redemption, greatly developed characters that I can latch onto, beautiful animation, beautiful soundtrack, and an amazing message that teaches the viewer that today's enemy can be tomorrow's friend. It's an excellent movie that I think everyone should watch at least once. A Silent Voice is truly a great movie. Number 7, The Dark Knight. There's a reason why the Dark Knight trilogy is regarded as one of the greatest film trilogies of all time, because they're all amazing movies. But out of the three movies, The Dark Knight is easily the best one. Every scene in this movie is a literal masterpiece. Some of the best moments in cinema, and it's because of Heath Ledger's performance as Joker. He stole the show. Every scene he's in, delivering some of the best acting for a film. But Ledger shouldn't get all the credit now. Christian Bale was incredible as well. Seeing Batman and Joker go back and forth is spectacular. I thought both Bale and Ledger were amazing enough individually, but together it's a recipe for perfection. The fantastic storytelling that's beautifully paced. Personally, it's rare to make a long-ass movie feel fast, but this movie found a way to do the impossible. The dark and realistic tone really departs The Dark Knight from any other superhero movie. The Dark Knight took a risk, and it paid off perfectly, making this, in my personal opinion, the greatest superhero movie of all time. Number 6, Nightcrawler. Nightcrawler has to be one of the best thrillers I've ever seen. There's so much to love here. The thing I like the most about Nightcrawler is its depiction on certain subject matters such as mainstream media, capitalism, as well as mind corruption. Seeing Jake Gyllenhaal's character slowly turning into a completely different person from the person who he was in the beginning of the movie, that shit was just great. And speaking of Jake Gyllenhaal, this motherfucker acted his ass off in this movie. Every word he says, every emotion he shows, you really feel it. His acting was that damn good. And despite the fact that he gradually turns into a criminal, you still root for him, even when he's completely lost it. The story was simple, yet it was deep and effective. The cinematography and the atmosphere are top notch, and the writing is spectacular. This movie also has one of, if not, my number one favorite quote in the film.
My motto is, if you want to win the lottery, you have to make the money to buy a ticket.
It's a simple quote, yeah, but it has so much meaning behind it to the point where it really hits you. Nightcrawler is such an amazing movie, and if you haven't watched Nightcrawler yet, please do so. I believe they just added it to Netflix. Watch that shit, because it's incredible. Number 5, Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi. Now, I know a lot of people love Empire Strikes Back. Hell, I love Empire Strikes Back. But personally, of the original three, I prefer Return of the Jedi. I'm not degrading the other two films. In fact, I love them. but I love Return of the Jedi the most. What I love about Return of the Jedi is that there's a lot going on. It is definitely the most fast-paced one of the three, with the non-stop action and different scenarios sprinkled in. It gives this movie a sense of consistency, as if there's no dull moment in the movie. I know a lot of people didn't like the Jabba's palace scene, but personally, I loved it. I thought it was interesting and well-paced enough for me to keep my attention. And that's what I love about Return of the Jedi. It's able to keep my attention the whole way through, doing a better job than the first two movies in my opinion. Not only that, but the climax was just great to watch. The emotional weight, the phenomenal music, the effects, the action, the ending, it makes the whole movie worth the watch. I think out of the three movies in the original trilogy, I watched Return of the Jedi the most. It was just an excellent movie that beautifully wrapped up the original trilogy. I love this movie, even after this scene.
Take a few steps back, you ugly bitch!
Number 4, Spider-Man. This has to be the most early 2000s movie I've ever seen. And personally, that's the charm of the movie. It gives me this nostalgic feel every time I watch it, which I appreciate more by each rewatch. Sam Raimi did a great job bringing the comics to life in movie form. I love the story, I love the characters, I love the action. It was great to watch while dated at the same time, yeah. The villain in this movie is great. Another actor that acted his ass off in the movie. Willem Dafoe killed the Green Goblin. He was amazing. The acting as a whole is pretty damn good. Yes, Spider-Man 2 is a better movie. I mean, that movie really covered deep shit. But I enjoyed Spider-Man 1 a little more. It's cheesy as hell, yet I fucking love the movie because of it. Spider-Man 1 is just cheesy fun. It's a very 2000s movie, but fuck it. I still think the movie's fire. Number 3, The Matrix. Even after all this time, this is still the best installment of the Matrix franchise. Now, don't get me wrong. I fucking love Reloaded. Easily the best Matrix sequel. But the first one will forever be the best. This movie has a deep, compelling, and complex story that really makes you question about the mere concept of reality. This movie also has greatly written characters, cutting edge and intense action sequences, and a damn good soundtrack. This movie requires your full attention, because there's little details representing symbolism that's easy to miss. When I rewatched this movie, I was like, damn, how did I miss this? Damn, how did I miss that? I love that about the movie. The Matrix is a movie anyone can enjoy. Whether you're a casual movie watcher or a cinephile, I can almost guarantee that you'll enjoy The Matrix. Number 2, Toy Story 2. This movie really holds a special place in my heart. This is not only my first Pixar movie, but one of the first movies I've ever seen. Out of all the Toy Story movies, Toy Story 2 is my favorite one. What I love about this one is how it really expands upon the lore of the franchise. In the previous one, it was about a toy in the eyes of a kid. But in this one, it's a toy in the eyes of a collector. You learn new things about the old characters, such as Woody's background, and a different side of certain characters that's never seen in the first movie. The characters are amazing. The recurring characters go through great character development, and even the newly introduced characters have some depth in them. The shit that the characters have been through is massively impactful to their personalities, both old and new. That, and it's pivotal to the overall plot of the movie. The animation is a huge upgrade from the first one. It's very colorful and the animation really has a lot to offer. Hell, this movie came out in 1999 and the animation aged beautifully. There is so much to like about Toy Story 2. And the fact that this was Pixar's first sequel is mind-blowing. This just shows that Pixar is the GOAT, despite its duds. Okay, we're down to the number one pick. This might come to a surprise for some of y'all, considering that only a select few know my number one pick. With that being said, my number one favorite movie of all time is Akira. Where do I begin with Akira? There's just a fuck ton of things to love about this movie. The story is an eventful ride that starts off simple but gradually gets deeper and more complex. It eventually becomes more psychological, more political, more historical. I love the various themes tackled here. I love the characters in this movie. I find each character to be likable and well written. I do think the characters are much better in the manga, but I still love them regardless. Also, I gotta say this, Akira has some of the best 2D animation I've ever fucking seen, point blank. The smallest details, the smooth movements, the colors, everything is fantastic in the animation department. The action scenes are greatly crafted, the soundtrack is incredibly atmospheric. This movie has everything you want in a good movie. Yes, the manga is obviously way better, but the movie is still a masterpiece. It's like Berserk in a way, where yes, the manga is the ultimate experience, but the anime, the 90s one by the way, is still phenomenal. Akira is not only my favorite movie of all time, but in my opinion, Akira is the greatest anime movie of all time. I've seen this movie a lot, a fucking lot, and I read the manga a couple of times. I just love this franchise a lot. So there you have it, my top 10 favorite movies of all time. This gotta be a long ass fucking video. But I know this shit's worth it. It was great looking back at all these movies. Will I do more top 10 videos? I don't fucking know. Let's see. Alright, I'm out.